Something's Cooking Culinary Arts Private Limited.
Well, till at least marketing is going to be working for me today.
Till we get his presentation up, exactly 6 minutes. We're stopping everyone exactly at 6 minutes. 2 minutes for the questions round. You can also give them tips, pointers. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Something's Cooking Culinary Arts.
Good afternoon. My name is Satish. 4 weeks ago, I got an inquiry from a CEO of a software company. This company is into developing simulation software to create experiential learning and assessment platforms for their customers. So when I met him over coffee, one of the things that he mentioned to me was, I've got a lot of new people who joined the organization, right? And we are a company which is into doing products which do not have a benchmark in the market. So how do I get these people to understand and how to operate in that environment? The second challenge was around how do they handle situations around time when the time that the customer gives is significantly below what is estimated. So we put in a lot of effort in trying to design a program for them which was looking at a behavioral change, and thought went into the menu design and into how the execution is going to be. We created a 3-course menu for them. We gave them the recipes with the ingredients on it. They had to not only estimate the time that was needed for this particular activity, but also looking at what are the name of the dishes. As you can imagine, cooking a lasagna is tough, but not knowing it's a lasagna makes it tougher. So they came back and said, hey, we need three hours. Like any good customer, I went up and said, no, you're going to get only 1 hour, 45 minutes. And they cooked it in 1 hour, 45 minutes. Post the food, food that they ate, there was a debriefing session that took place, and they committed to learnings based on that, on what they're going to do when they go back to the organization. All of this was done in 5 hours and at 35% of the cost of a traditional training program. Ladies and gentlemen, we present Something's Cooking Culinary Arts to you. Come together, cook together, have a meal together. And all of this in a completely state-of-the-art, world-class kitchen. In fact, one of the participants said, you've almost created a reality show. I feel like being in a MasterChef television series. As you may know, the sociology of cooking plays a very major role in our lives. For those of you who live in joint families, they would relate to the fact that while there may be many rooms, there's only one kitchen in the entire house. Bonding takes place, conflict resolution takes place, political discussions take place over there. When you look at, the approach that we've taken in the past for training programs has been to take people for bonding in our typical outbound kind of scenarios. Outbound worked very well when the consequence of non-participation was very high. We took them out of their comfort zones into an area where they had to actually do things, and if they did not participate, it was pretty much dangerous. But what we've done in the last several years is that we've taken our luxuries into the resorts, into creating resorts for outbound, right? So the consequence of non-participation has diminished quite a bit. When you look at group cooking as an activity, there's a lot of co-creation that takes place. In the co-creation, there's a lot of learning that can come out. And the second thing around it is the fact that there's a sensory satiety. This is probably the only activity where you get to see, touch, smell it, hear it, and eventually get to taste it as well. Right? So you can do a lot with using culinary activities for corporate initiatives. Right? It's not just for corporate initiatives. Now, can you imagine, when you're doing transition management, how do you bring about a behavioral changes? When you're doing team bonding, you can certainly do that as well. The amount of joy that people get by co-creating, it's significantly higher than going through an achievement part of it. What we are looking at is being a pioneer in the space of using culinary activities for corporate initiatives as well as for team bonding and learning. We want to be in different cities in the country. Our mission is to be creating finger-licking culinary experiences and experiences in a world-class studio. It's a very non-threatening environment. And the team that's there to put this together is a combination of corporate experience and culinary expertise. I've done a lot of time in the corporate world in leadership roles in HR, and my team has done, being chefs in international companies as well. Having been in existence for 3 months, what we have done is corporate team building, we've done leadership family get-togethers, we've done birthday parties, and we've done things around learning, which is for individuals, which is cooking classes for children and cooking classes for adults. The key, you know, to any business is to have a secret ingredient. And the secret ingredient for us is adding laughter to taste. What we want to achieve through Antaprerna is, being the pioneers, we're looking at expansion over a period of time. Right? We want to have market connect. We want to have people who can advise us being the part of our team. And then also looking at the very fact that using this as a platform for creating much more learning experiences going forward. So that's something's cooking for all of you. And I'm happy to answer questions now.
I'm curious, what got you started down this path?
About 9 years ago, I went through a cooking experience when I was the head of HR for a company, and probably the first time that I got to know my global colleagues on a level which was beyond work. And it was on my mind for the last 9 years to see, you know, how can we do something like this in India? And probably 9 years ago when I thought about it, the market was not ready. When you look at cooking today as a social activity, it has transformed in the country. 9 years ago, it was still a very home-based, city kind of activity. So that's where the journey started 9 years ago.
So this is done in your center, sorry.
Yeah, we have two models. We have one model where we get people to come into our studio to do this activity. But we can also devise programs, and we've done it, where we can go to an outside location and get them to do a similar culinary activity, where the principles of learnings are also built in.
But is it a viable business model?
It is. Because of two things. One is, you're looking at a significant productivity gain for companies because of the fact that it's in an urban setting, so you don't have to go to an outbound to do learning and development kind of activities. That's one part of it. The second part of it is that the entire experiential part of it leads to a lot of learning. And you know, you can create this. So this is almost like what outbound was for the corporate world about 15 years ago.
35 seconds.
How do your economics work out?
We charge per person, and if it's a, you know, it depends on the kind of activity and the cuisine, right? If it's a very customized program, then there is a fee that is different because of the fact that there is customizing and a lot of consulting that goes in. And if it's a standard, come cook together, have fun together, you know, so then we've got a standard pricing for that.
Is it positioned more as a learning sort of activity, or is it more, since you said fun with laughter with taste or something, is it more a fun activity as far as the corporates are concerned?
So for the corporates, there are two parts that we are looking at. One is, when you look at team bonding, you know, like a team get together. So instead of going to a restaurant, having these long tables of 20-25 people sitting, instead of, you know, there is no social conversation that's taking place, that can become a memorable event. That's more the fun part of it. Now, using the culinary activities as a platform for, you know, creating learning avenues, that's the learning part of it. So there are both the components that we look at.
Something's cooking, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together for them, please.